Hello, good morning, evening, middle of the day, whenever you're watching this. Hope your day has been well. If not, I hope it gets better. Today, we are drawing Prince Zuko from Avatar The Last Airbender and Lelouch or Zero from Code Geass. I only recently started watching Code Geass, and well, I haven't finished it, I suppose. I finished season one, but I haven't done season two yet. However, I dare say that it has jumped very high on my list of favorite anime. Depending on how season two goes, it might just stay there. And of course, I have no argument with people saying that Avatar is one of the best American cartoons of recent time. Serialized story, I suppose, you know, whatever. Continuous. Because that was also a fantastic story, one of my favorites. That way, also. If you consider it an anime, you know, it's very inspired by anime, so I don't see why not, but at the same time, I understand the argument against it being an anime. Anyway, the reason I'm drawing this is because somebody made a joke that Lelouch and Zuko were very similar characters. They're both sort of the plotting emo character, and they have a similar hairstyle. At least Zuko in most of season 3 has that, you know. And that sort of center lock, center spike thing going on, a lot of anime characters have. I tried that one time with my hair for a cosplay, and it was very irritating to maintain that center lock. Some people might be able to pull it off better than I. Anyway, the reason that I drew Zuko in this royal garb, I believe he wore this while he was back with the Fire Nation at the beginning of season 3, but of course, I know that he had that when he was, you know, took over as the new Fire Lord. The good Fire Lord. Did he change the title? I don't remember. It's been a while since I watched it. I should start watching it again. Anyway, I chose that one because it seemed, you know, as sort of flamboyant and authoritative as Zero's costume. So, when I started watching Code Geass, of course, I think it was the first two episodes, they immediately immediately drew me in, and I thought they were fantastically well written and excellent, very excellent. However, as the show went on for a while, I still enjoyed it, but I began to think that it just might be... Now, don't take this like I'm saying there's nothing wrong with it, but it's sort of the perfect anime, in a way. Like I said, not that there's nothing wrong with it, but that, like, it's super marketable, I guess. The appeal factor, there's so much in it that it can appeal to, like, any sort of anime you're looking to watch. It's there. It's doing it. I'm not sure how to describe it quite right, but, you know, it's got robot battles, it's got politics, you know, pseudo-politics, pseudo-philosophy, I guess, if that's what you want to call it. It has sort of like, you know, it deals with sort of darker themes a lot of the times. But it also has, like, you know, high school drama, you know, but, like, everything's sort of idealized. So, like, you know, the main character's that sort of character you can, I don't know, sort of idolize in a way. Not completely, because he's also kind of, you know, that edgy guy. It's kind of hard to explain exactly my reasoning, but it just seems like it has so much broad appeal to so many different, you know, demographics of viewers, but it pulls it together really well, I feel. And like I said, you know, it's not 100% perfect. It's not like there's nothing wrong with it. However, you know, but anyway, realize that Zuko kind of looks like Azula here, which I guess also kind of works, kind of, but, you know, give me the scar. So for the flame effect, what I did was I used, I think the brush is called Kyle's Real Oils, for the brush strokes, and did different colors, and then I used the smudge tool. And then I copied the layer and did another layer on top with the sort of, with the oils brush again. And then added the glow effect with one of the soft brushes. And then I basically did the same sort of technique for doing the geese in his eye, in Lelouch's eye. But yeah, it's probably a good thing I didn't discover Code Geass earlier. I discovered it when I was in, like, middle school, high school, something like that. I don't know. I probably would have tried to fantasize escaping into it too much, or try to be too much like the characters. I don't know. So it's an interesting thing, because now Now when I watch shows, I have a better appreciation for filmmaking. And so... And of course a better... of course a better grasp on real life than I did back in the day. I guess. I don't know. I'm just rambling on. But when I watch shows like Avatar and Code Geass, I can respect them more as shows than simply using them as escapism. Not that escapism is always bad. I feel like there are times when, and there are ways to use it well, you know. I definitely think that, I definitely think it can be used to good effect, but, you know, you get lost in escapism, you know, too much, then, well, you know, it's not good to completely lose touch with the real world. But if you never stop using your imagination, you never have to completely grow up. Never have to lose a childlike wonder. It'll help get you through life. I don't know what I'm talking about anymore. The drawing, yes. It took me a long time to do this one, partly because I was having some Photoshop problems. Partly because I kept breaking to go do other things, and partly because it's a very complicated picture, more complicated than I thought it'd be. Anyway, hope you had fun. We'll do it again sometime. See you later.